Greetings, everyone, and welcome back to Microsoft's Java for Beginners series. I'm here with Sandra Ahlgrimm today, and Sandra's going to talk to us about numeric data types. Sandra, do you want to tell us a little bit about yourself and about numeric data types?
Hi, Brian. Thank you for having me. Yeah, so my name is Sandra Ahlgrimm. I'm a cloud developer advocate working for Microsoft, and I just finished university, maybe 5 years ago. And when I started there, I also learned everything about numeric data types. So we thought, why not bringing it back to the community and bringing it back to you? You should be aware what numeric data types are. What are the different kinds of? Is it still necessary to know it? As probably for numbers, everyone uses int. But yes, even though our servers and devices are getting much more powerful, you might have scenarios where also the little bytes and pieces are very relevant for your performance and for your memory. So you should know about this. Also for floating data types, you should be aware how to use them correctly and how to calculate something with that. So I fear that this is very relevant to you and you should definitely have a look at this. Let's talk about numeric data types in Java. I just created a new project, a new Java project in VS Code to discuss this one here with you and also do some calculations to talk about the precision of various data types. So first of all, let's start with a byte. So a byte is 8 bits big and it can have any numbers between minus 128 and 127. A short is useful for bigger numbers or smaller numbers. So if, for instance, if I have 128, I can have a short number. It can have any values between minus 32,768 up to 32,767. If you need even bigger numbers, you can use an integer. And here you see the primitive representation of it. And if you want to have the maximum value, you can just use the mathematic object here. So the Java lang integer, it's just from the Java language. So here you have the integer max value and the value is, here you can see it and read it by yourself. If you need an even bigger number, you would look for a long value because integers are only 32 bits tall. And for a long value, you need to add a small or a capital letter L here. To make it easier to read, I would always go for the capital L because otherwise a small L would too much look like a 1. So I would always go and prefer the capital letters here. So, and then I can system out print all of these values here. And if I have floating numbers, I would go for either float or double. For float, I also need to add the F here. I would also stick with the capital one, or I go with double. And here I can also print out those numbers. But there are some concerns for the precision of these numbers. So let's print that out and run it here. So there we go. And I have my hello byte with the equals 2. We put them up here. So that's correct. And short, int, and long numbers. Also, I have my float numbers 2.4 here. But my calculation puts out 1.6. And then it's not just 1.6, what I would have expected, right? Because we have 1.9 minus 1.3. But instead of 1.6, it's 1.600000001. So that's not very precise. I mean, for some cases, it might not matter. But if I need to do any text calculations or others where I need to have this precision, I would go for big decimal. And for big decimal, I can use the value of and then put here my double values inside. And then I can use the subtract method and print out the precise value of 1.6.
Thanks, Sandra. That was great.
Thanks. Now you should be aware when to use what numeric data types.
And please check out the rest of our Java for Beginners series.